bones to the ground, far from the rivers. Grace in our tears, high on a fever. Somebody heal me from my pain.
The cucumbers, yeah. How's the feel?
It feels
weird.
Does it? Does it?
Yeah.
So funny.
My friend told me that a couple of years ago. And you believe it, Siobhan, and then you started to use it this summer.
Chest, I couldn't put a hand on my chest now at all. It would come out like very spotty.
Yeah.
The bronzer works. Sometimes even bronzer, depending on it.
From my chains.
Well, no, once the sword passes,
you know what I mean? I have to renew my driver's license.
He's still on his
own.
Got all the people to move.
Church of St. Peter and St. Paul in Dunboyne this afternoon, and a special welcome to Sean and Lorna as they come here to celebrate their marriage. The first thing we need to do is to ask them to make a declaration of no civil impediment. It's a requirement of the state that they do that publicly and in front of witnesses. So I'm going to put that to both of them individually. Sean Marchetti, do you know of any civil impediment to the marriage that you are about to enter with Lorna Birmingham?
No.
And Lorna Birmingham, do you know of any civil impediment to the marriage you are about to enter with Sean Marchetti?
No.
Good. if it was anything else, we'd be leaving here very quickly. So I'm going to ask Sean and Lorna now to light the two candles here in the arrangement at the centre of the altar. That signifies their uniqueness, their individuality and singleness as they come here today to pledge their loves and their lives to each other.
Thank you.
name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good again, good afternoon, everybody, and a very special welcome to our church here in Dunboyne. A particular welcome if you've travelled a long distance, or those who may have travelled from abroad to be here for this very special celebration, the marriage of Sean and Lorna. I welcome Lorna's parents, Frank and Louise, and also Sean's parents, Martino and Audrey, their family, two granddads, and a grandmother as well. All of the other guests, people that have come here today, all of these people have formed you in various ways over your life and have brought you to this day and made you what you are. And it's absolutely appropriate that they would here be with you today to celebrate this day, one of the most important days in your life, when you pledge your life and your love to another person for life. We do so when we come here asking God to bless your marriage, but also to give you the grace and the strength to be able to live out the vows that you make. Those vows are made by two human beings, and we do need God's help and God's grace to be able to give expression to them. And that grace is guaranteed by God in the sacrament of marriage. We acknowledge our shortcomings as we call to mind our sins. But as we do so, we're always relying on the mercy and the love and the compassion of God. So let us pause for a moment and let us kneel as we call them to mind. We say together, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. We praise God in the words of the glory as we pray. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. We pray this day for Lorna and Sean. Father, hear our prayers for Lorna and Sean, who today are united in marriage before your altar. Give them your blessing. Strengthen their love for each other. We ask this prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated now for the readings. The first reading will be read by Cora, and the second reading then will be read by Fiona. So I invite both of them to come forward.
The first reading, a reading from the Song of Songs, Love as Strong as Death. Hark, my lover, here he comes, springing across the mountains, leaping across the hills. My lover is like a gazelle or a young stag. Here he stands behind our wall, gazing through the windows, peering through the lattices. My lover speaks. He says to me, arise, my beloved, my dove, my beautiful one, and come. O my dove, in the clefts of the rock, in the secret recesses of the cliff, let me see you, let me hear your voice, for your voice is sweet and you are lovely. My lover belongs to me and I to him. He says to me, set me as a seal on your heart, as a seal on your arm. For stern as death is love, relentless as the netherworld is devotion. Its flames are a blazing fire. Deep waters cannot quench love, nor floods sweep it away. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the prophet Jeremiah. See, the days are coming. It is the Lord who speaks, when I will make new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of Judah, but not like the one I made with their ancestors on the day I took them by the hand to bring them out of the land of Egypt. No, this is the covenant I will make with the house of Israel when those days arrive. It is the Lord who speaks. Deep within them I will plant my law, writing it on their hearts. Then I will be their God, and they shall be my people. There will be no further need for neighbor to try to teach neighbor, or brother to teach brother. Learn to know the Lord. They will all know me. The least no less than the greatest. It is the Lord who speaks. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. And we will say the responsorial psalm. The Lord fills the earth with his love. The Lord fills the earth with his love. They are happy whose God is the Lord, the people he has chosen as his own. The Lord looks on those who revere him, on those who hope in his love. The Lord fills the earth with his love. Our soul is waiting for the Lord. The Lord is our help and our shield. In him do our hearts find joy. We trust in his holy name. The Lord fills the earth with his love. May your love be upon us, O Lord, as we place all our hope in you. The Lord fills the earth with his love. Please stand for the gospel acclamation. As long as we love one another, God will live in us, and his love will be complete in us. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. There was a wedding at Cana in Galilee. The mother of Jesus was there, and Jesus and his disciples had also been invited. When they ran out of wine, since the wine provided for the wedding was all finished, the mother of Jesus said to him, "They have no wine." Jesus said, "Woman, why turn to me? My hour has not yet come." His mother said to the servants, "Do whatever he tells you." There were 6 stone jars standing there, meant for the ablutions that are customary among the Jews. Each could hold 20 or 30 gallons. Jesus said to the servants, "Fill the jars with water," and they filled them to the brim. "Draw some out now," he told them, "and take it to the steward." They did this. The steward tasted the water and it turned into wine. Having no idea where it came from, only the stewards who had drawn the water knew, the steward called the bridegroom and said, "People generally serve the best wine first and keep the cheaper sort till the guests have had plenty to drink. But you have kept the best wine till now." This was the first of the signs given by Jesus. It was given at Cana in Galilee. He let his glory be seen, and his disciples believed in him. The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated for a couple of moments. The readings that Lorna and Sean have chosen to initiate their life together suggest maybe something of what they have discovered about God's love up to this point in their lives. First, take of all that little selection that they have taken from the Song of Songs in the first reading, and it hints very quickly at what the whole book actually reveals, that true love between a man and a woman is a wonderfully human thing. The song doesn't provide a philosophical definition of love, but what it is, it's a collection of lyric poems, or maybe sometimes it's only fragments of poems about human love and courtship, such as it might be sung at a wedding. It's not peculiarly religious. If you read either that excerpt that you've chosen, or indeed if you were to read the whole book, it's not a religious, because it is really, there, as I said, there are songs that could be sung at a wedding. But it is movingly human, and at times there are segments of it that are exceedingly erotic. It tells of a man and a woman caught up in each other, utterly, in wildly in love. That's what brought Lorna and Sean here today, because if that human love that's drawn them to each other, if they weren't wildly in love, they would never have walked up that aisle today, and they certainly would never walk down it, because that's what brings any couple together in life, is their love and friendship with each other. That's what that first reading is celebrating. The song, I suppose you'd say, is the dream of all lovers, the very human love that is God's own creation, where a man and a woman are drawn to each other in a very unique fashion, so that they yearn and they absolutely desire, before all else, to share themselves totally, mind and heart, body and spirit, in the way that they would share with no other person this side of heaven. That's what Lorna and Sean come here to do, to pledge that love, that type of love, to each other from this day forward. And when you have this kind of love that I've just described, it's no wonder that the reading at the very beginning says that it is love as strong as death. Such is the love that Lorna and Sean have for each other, and that love they want to declare publicly before family and friends, because marriage is a public event. We declare it before witnesses. It's not done in private or in the back of a car or in the back kitchen, but it's always public, where we make our love known before everybody else, and we want the world to know about it. In contemporary culture, I suppose love has become one of those very sometimes ambiguous and certainly a very much abused word. Sometimes it has become a commodity that is to be bought and sold, that is to be traded and bartered, sometimes even priced and packaged. And many in the world that we live in, unfortunately, seek love as a thing, as an asset to be acquired, as a commodity, if you like, to be possessed and hoarded and banked. And just as that doesn't work, for when we try to store it up, it actually decays and perishes. There's a lovely poem by Seamus Heaney called Blackberry Picking. In that poem, he talks about picking blackberries and going out into the highways and byways and picking the lovely fruit, which looked so ripe and juicy on the brambles. He brought them home and he stored them in a bath, hoping to come back to them. And they went back the next day and discovered that it had just turned to a foul, rotting mess when it was hoarded. Love is somewhat similar. If it's genuine, it cannot be possessive, otherwise it will decay and rot just as surely as the blackberries did in Seamus Heaney's poem. The second reading that you've chosen from the prophet Jeremiah, I think it's one of the most, it's the most profoundest and the most moving passages in the entire Bible, not just in the Old Testament, but also in the New Testament. What it says is that there is no need for intermediaries, such as Moses, priests, prophets, or people can intervene directly with God. And the result is that God's people will recognize God's action in every situation. And this time, says everybody will be faithful. Man and woman will be created or recreated with human intelligence and with the willpower to fulfill God's plan for them. That's what Lorna and Sean come here today, is to fulfill the will and the purpose of God. because they, out of reflection, out of their time together so far in life, have discerned that the will and purpose of God for them is that they should commit their lives and their love to each other from this day forward. And the freedom that Lorna and Sean have through faith is a freedom, if you like, to render the service of love. Freedom for them is the freedom to serve one another in marriage from this day forward. You're very aware, I'm sure, of all the changes that have come to you over the years. These are the changes that have shaped you in one way or another into the two in one flesh. And that change is far more difficult, in my view, than the miracle that's described of changing the 120 gallons of water into wine in the marriage feast of Cana. For the miracle of Cana, if you like, changed water that could not possibly resist the power of God's Son. But today, the miracle that has shaped the unity between Sean and Lorna, you're always free to say no to God's human grace that's given to you, because that's what it means to be human. It's the possibility to say no, the possibility sometimes not to be kind, not to be compassionate, the possibility to be sometimes difficult and pig-headed, maybe when we should be compliant. And that's a wonderful thing, because otherwise, what will we be? We'd be nothing but robots with somebody else pulling the strings. Today, you come here to this church. It's a wedding day. It's a single day. It's about making the promises. Marriage is something different. It's about a lifetime. It's about trying to keep the promises. I would suggest, if you think there's a, ask your parents. They would have made these promises, and your grandparents, many, many years and moons ago. And they were easy to make, but they certainly took a lot of commitment, a lot of energy, and with God's help and God's grace, they were able to keep them. So, you know, if you remember that marriage is that covenant, not between two saints, but between two imperfect images of God. And we're always frail, forgetful, and we have our own will. And sometimes we can be self-willed, sometimes we can unleash our frustrations, and they usually get unleashed on the person that we care about most and love most. But what we need to do there is, in some sense, to look at the way Jesus Christ loved. And that's not easy. It demands of Lorna and Sean that you focus and fix your eyes not on yourself, but on the other person. And that other person often has three faces. It's the face of the person that's sitting beside you. Secondly, it's the face of God. And thirdly, it's the face of the human community that's around you, principally these people that you have here today. Because marriage never survives in a splendid isolation, but it survives and thrives and prospers because of the support of the community in which you live. That's why you have these people here today. They're here with you, not just as spectators to watch a spectacle, but in some sense, their presence here is a reminder or a promise. It's a reminder, first of all, to you that Lorna and Sean need you not to fulfill the church and make a big crowd here in a very large church, but it's to gift them with your experience, to gift them with your example, to gift them with your courage. And it's also a promise that you will be there in the future, not just today, this particular Saturday, but they'll be there when you call on them and when you need them, with gifts that are far more precious than the gifts that they've given you. In other words, they're there with some compassion in their listening, with an attentive pair of ears, with eyes that are seeing, and with caring in their hearing. So I pray that they will always be there for you in the years ahead. And it's also an opportunity for everybody else in the congregation to renew their own vows, because sometimes you make these vows here on a particular day, the 10th of September, but we do need to renew the vows every so often. And a wedding, when a couple are making their vows, is an opportunity for everybody else to renew the commitment that they made many, many years ago. So without further ado, I'm going to ask Lauren and Sean to stand and to make their marriage vows here for family and friends. Dear Lorna and Sean, you have come here to this Church of St. Peter and Paul today to pledge your love before God and before the Church, here present in my person and before your family and your friends. In becoming husband and wife, you give yourselves to each other for life. You promise to be true and faithful, to support and cherish each other until death, so that your years together will be the living out in love of the pledge you now make. May your love for each other reflect the enduring love of Christ for his Church. As you face the future together, keep in mind that the sacrament of marriage unites you with Christ and brings you, through the years, the grace and blessing of God our Father. Marriage is from God. He alone can give you the happiness which goes beyond human expectation and which grows deeper through the difficulties and struggles of life. Put your trust in God as you set out together in life. Make your home the center of Christian family life. In this, you will bequeath to your children a heritage more lasting than temporal wealth. The Christian home makes Christ and his Church present in the world of everyday living. May all who enter your home find there the presence of the Lord, for he said, "Where two or three are gathered together in my name, there I am in the midst of them." Sean and Lorna, now that you are about to exchange your marriage vows, the Church wishes to be assured that you appreciate the meaning of what you do. And so I ask you, have you come here of your own free will and choice and without compulsion to marry each other?
We have.
Will you love and honour each other in marriage all the days of your life?
We will.
And are you willing to accept with love the children God may send you and bring them up in accordance with the law of Christ and his Church?
We are.
I invite you then to declare before God and his Church your consent to become husband and wife.
I, Sean, take you, Lorna, as my wife, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and health, all the days of our life.
I, Lorna, take you, Sean, as my husband, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, all the days of our lives.
What God joins together, man must not separate. May the Lord confirm the consent that you have given and enrich you with his blessings. Amen. We now bless the rings. May the Lord bless these rings that will be a sign of your love and fidelity. We ask this blessing through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Lorna, wear this ring as a sign of my faithful love in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Sean, wear this ring as a sign of my faithful love in the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Push.
There you go.
This is the right size. So, congratulations to Mr. and Mrs. Marchetti.
So, what do you use like the candle now, the large candle? Okay, yeah. Just be careful on the steps.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm now going to invite Sean and Lorna to come and to light the centre candle here on the altar. This candle symbolizes their sacramental union in the sacrament of marriage.
Good.
Please stand now for the prayer of the faithful. And invite Bridget and Aileen and Sinead and Philip and Jeff and James to lead us in the prayer of the faithful.
No, yeah. No, it's not coming off. Yeah. Must be warm.
Yeah. We bring our prayers and our petitions today for Lorna and for the community to God.
God our Father, on this special day, we ask you to bless Lorna and Sean on their journey through life, to keep them in good health and grant them all the graces necessary to fill the promise they have made to each other. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For their parents, their friends, and all who have helped them to this happy day, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
May all married couples here today be reminded of the joy of their own day. May they give thanks for the happiness they have known, and may each day find them more devoted to each other. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For our friends and families and relatives who departed this life, and for all of those fated to depart us, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For those who are sick, that they find relief. For those who care for them, that they find strength. And for those who grieve, they find comfort. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for those who mourn while we are rejoicing, that in their suffering and loneliness, they may experience the strength of God's support. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. We thank you, Lord, and we praise you for bringing Lorna and Sean to this happy day. You have given them to each other. Now together, they give themselves to you. We ask you, Lord, to make them one in their love, keep them one in your peace. Protect their marriage, bless their home, keep them gentle, make them faithful. And when life is over, unite them again where parting is no more in the kingdom of your love. There they will praise you in the happiness and peace of our eternal home. We ask this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. And please be seated now for the offertory procession. And the gifts will be brought forward by Rory, Paul and Dara. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Lord, accept our offering for this newly married couple, Lorna and Sean. By your love and providence, you have brought them together. Now bless them all the days of their married life, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Now ask Lauren and Sean to kneel for the nuptial blessing. This prayer takes the place of the prayer, Deliver us, Lord, in the Mass of Marriage. Let us ask God to bless Lorna and Sean, now married in Christ, and unite them in his love through the sacrament of his body and blood. God, our Father, creator of the universe, you made man and woman your own likeness and blessed their union. We humbly pray to you today for Lorna and Sean, today united in the sacrament of marriage. May your blessing come upon them. May they find happiness in their love for each other. Be blessed in their children and enrich the life of the church. May they praise you in their days of happiness and turn to you in times of sorrow. May they know the joy of your help in their work and the strength of your presence in their need. May they worship you with the church and be your witnesses in the world. And may old age come to them in the company of their friends, and may they reach at last the kingdom of heaven. We ask this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And we offer to each other now a sign of that peace that was brought by Jesus Christ.
Congratulations.
Cheers, man.
A little sweaty there.
Huh? It's the crack.
All right, man.
Peace be with you.
Yeah. Congratulations, man.
Done.
Peace be with you. Congratulations.
Cheers.
Well done.
Peace be with you. Sorry. Peace be with you. Hey, peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. How are you going? Cheers. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to welcome you all here to Ballymacarvan Village. I hope you're enjoying your day. Can we all now be please outstanding for a new boy in the room, Mr. and Mrs. Marchetti.
Beautiful fiance. It's great to look around, see so many familiar faces, as well as people that I've just met tonight and people that I've still yet to meet. So we do just want to say thank you very much. That's for everybody betting out there. Thank you very much for everybody to make the effort and coming out tonight. Now on the subject of betting, I have heard that there's, you know, a couple of tabs going on different tables, so I've squared it with the house. So I want to make sure we're turning a blind eye, and I've cut my deals with a few of yous out there, right? So, you know yous are. We're lucky enough to have guests coming from very far away in exotic lands, likes of Spain, Italy, France, and of course, Clonmel. But on a more serious note, I am delighted to say that my brother has found his soulmate, and for that I congratulate the both of you. Lorna, from the first day you came into our lives, you've been nothing but a positive impact on both myself and the rest of the family. Being honest, I actually can't remember the first day we met. I have a brief memory of Sean doing a quick, you know, stealth job, getting you in and out without anybody knowing. As you do, you're not away. But since then, you've been nothing but positive, and it's been all good and absolute pleasure. And I'm delighted to say I can finally call you my sister officially. And welcome to the family. And of course, today you look absolutely stunning, as I'm sure everybody will agree. Accompanied, of course, by your six lovely bridesmaids, you're all surrounded around me. I've had the pleasure of meeting most of you before and getting to know all of you. And the love and support that you have for each other, I can see where Lorna gets her positivity and her energy. So you're all a credit to each other. As for the lads, all right, boys. We made it here, that's the main thing. You will see a video come up of the drive here. It'll be on Facebook by the end of the week, and Jesus Christ, we made it. That's the fucking main thing. And Glenn, there is a taxi, you know, on standby, just in case we need to go to the A&E later, right? I will do a brief mention of the stag. For those of you who don't know, we did go to Amsterdam for a trance festival. So as you can imagine, you know, strict guidelines is what I can and cannot say. We made it. We got Sean back in one piece, which is the main thing, obviously. Credit has to be given to Keith, who made it you know, the whole way at Sean's side, 72 hours of pure trance. So for that, fair play. And something when you're traveling and you're going off around the world, something you can come back to. Definitely, Luma next year. So bear with me 1 second. So before I pass you over to Frank, I'd like to thank all the staff, obviously, here at Ballymacarvey Village. The place looks absolutely amazing. Thank you, Monsignor Dermot, for an absolutely lovely ceremony earlier today. It was absolutely beautiful. I know they're not here, but thank you to the musicians who played absolutely beautiful music on the way up the church. And to obviously the photographers and the videographers who are going to be capturing everything and making everything absolutely beautiful. Finally to Sean, as my only brother, I'm very, very grateful for the support and the friendship we have, as well as the love we have for each other, our family, and for life in general. So once more, I congratulate you on your beautiful bride and this beautiful day, and I wish you all the happiness that life can bring. Lorna. Benvenuto a Famiglia Marchetti, I tanti giorni per 100 anni. Oggi, una pioggia di fiori, domani, sorrisi dei bambini. And I'll tell you what that means later on. later on. I'm going to pass you all over to my father just to say a couple of words.
Right, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. On the behalf of myself and Audrey, you're all very welcome here to this beautiful Ballymacarvey to celebrate Lorna and Sean's wedding. We're very grateful for you all. I know you've travelled from all over the country, particularly Tipperary. Well done last week. Excellent. And just a quick mention to my cousin who flew in from Italy and her husband, Matilda Nagisto, and to Pete and Jan who came from Spain. And I know others travelled from other parts of the country. You're all very welcome, and thanks very much for coming. And just also a quick mention, my father is here tonight. It's great to have all generations, from the very youngest down below to my father, who's Sean's grandfather, and also Frank's mother was at the church earlier, and Paddy, who's sitting somewhere right. Great to have you all here. As I say, it's great to have all generations here together. It really is fantastic. Officially, Lorna, I'd like to welcome you into the Marchetti family. Now, I know Sam has said it all, but officially, you're very, very welcome. I think we met you about 8 years ago or so, is that right? And basically, from the moment we met you, it was like we always knew you. It was like you were always part of our family. And it's just great to have you part of our family. You know, and your parents, we've had a few good times together. We've been away on holidays and look forward to a lot more of that, you know, in the future. So, yeah, that's fantastic. But that's really all I have to say. Everyone have a fantastic evening tonight. Thank you all for coming. And I'll pass you back to Sam. Slán lat.
Great stuff. I'm going to pass you over to Frank just to say a couple of words.
Thanks very much. I think I know you're all looking forward to a great speech, but I think you're going to have to wait for Louise's one because this is rubbish. But anyway, I won't repeat a lot of what Sam and Tino have said. I mean, thank to everybody for the travelling the long distance. Okay, I'm going to say appreciate now instead of thank for now. We know it's a lot of expense and for people to come here. It's a lot of travelling for people, and we really appreciate the effort that everybody's made to do that. And while Sam and Tino have welcomed Lorna to their family, equally I'd like to welcome Sean to our family. While Sean has been living in Clonmel for the last few years, or last year and a half or so, Louise and myself have got to know him very well. I think he's a really nice guy, and I think Lorna and himself are very well suited. I think they bring out the best in each other, and hopefully they'll have a great life together. Now, Lorna, I wasn't going to mention too many of Lorna's eccentric qualities, but then I said, well, what the hell, it's my last chance, so I'll give it a go. So think as many of you who may have visited us when Lorna was a young child, one thing she wasn't great at was sleeping. In fact, she would fight going to sleep and would try to stay awake and be in the centre of whatever action was going on. I think for about the first 15 years of life, she had really no interest in going to sleep. I think it's probably fair to say that Louise and myself weren't prepared for the trials of having a child and the getting up in the middle of the night and changing nappies and all that, and the lack of sleep. But we didn't expect it to last for 15 years, in fairness. But I mean, the lack of sleep, not the change of the nappies. I remember we had one particular incident. I think Lorna was about 6 months old at the time, and I was working all day. I came home, and Louise was tearing her hair out. Lorna had been very cross and was awake, I think, all day and probably the previous night. And I think Louise said something to me like, she'd heard that people take kids for a drive in the car to try to get them to sleep. And I think my answer was something along the lines of, you know, what class of age is it about driving around with a child in the car trying to get them to sleep? But I think about half an hour later, we're driving down the Walford Road, yeah. With Lorna strapped to the back seat. So we're down a couple of miles and things are fairly quiet. We think, Jesus, this is not, maybe this is working, you know? So we got near Kilsheelan and we kind of looked at one another and said, Jesus, this looks okay. So we pulled the car over, looked around, and there's Lorna strapped to the back seat, two eyes popping out of her head, looking around to see what's going on. So we turned the car around and hit for home for another 14 and a half years of no sleep. So there was it. in fairness though, one thing Lorna was great at was studying. She was always great to study as a child. Sorry, that's a typing mistake. That should be partying, sorry. She was always great at partying. And I don't know where she could have got that from, Louise. But yeah. No, but seriously, Lorna is a great girl and she's a great daughter. I would say she looks great today, but you know, in general, she's a great sense of humour. She's a kind-hearted person, very generous, very thoughtful. She looks great today, and I'd say Louise and myself are very, very proud to have her as a daughter. So just on a more serious note, there's a few people that we would love to have with us here today. My own father, Jim, Louise's mother, Teresa, and both of Audrey's parents, Jane Ann and Eddie. We'd love to have them here. They'd love to be here, and I'm sure they're with us in spirit anyway. And just a few other people that I think Louise and Lauren in particular are very close to that are no longer with us. That would be Nodie Hogan, Seamus Quinlan, and Peggy Maher. But it is great that... it's great that, as Tino mentioned, his father, David, is here. My own mother, Betty, was at the church earlier, but she couldn't make it here. And Betty has a significant birthday this day next week. Now that she's not here, I can say her age. She's 85 this day next week. And Paddy is here as well, of course. Paddy is still celebrating after Mastermind and Tips victory last week. And, I'm sure Paddy is looking forward to having a chat with all the Tipperary people who live in Waterford, who think supporting Waterford is a good idea. just thanks to Father Farrell as well for a lovely ceremony. We met Father Farrell for the first time on Thursday night. We went through the rehearsal, and he was very good, put us through our paces very well. And I don't think I've ever seen a man get six women to toe the line in 5 seconds flat. I'll have to get a few tips off him on that one. I'm nearly there. Nearly. How am I doing on time? Did I win the bet yet? No? And just the final thing, I suppose, I'd like to say a special thanks to Louise as well for all her hard work. I think for all the parents, there's a bit of work involved in this. Like Lauren and Sean have done a lot of the spade work, in fairness, but I think for the mother of the bride, it's a special occasion. I think Louise has put a huge effort in. I think Louise has put a special effort in over the last few months and a few sleepless nights and worrying about what was going to happen. So it's great that she's, this has all come to pass today. And I suppose for Louise's sisters, Anne and Fiona, I think have been very supportive of her as well. And just a final thing, it's great that Lorna's godfather John and his wife Ruth are here as well. They've travelled from the UK. We haven't seen them for a few years, so we're looking forward to catching up later on. So just finally, just want to thank everybody again for coming. And I think this is a great venue. I think Lorna and Sean really did all the spade work in terms of finding this place and setting it up. But now that we're here, I think we should make the best of it and have a good night and a good day tomorrow as well. Okay? Great. Thanks very much. Thanks.
Finally, I'm going to pass you over to Sean just to say a couple of words.
How's it going, everybody? There are a few hard acts to follow, so you'll have to bear with me. First of all, on behalf of my beautiful new wife and I'd like to thank you all sincerely for making the effort to be here today. As the guys have said, I know you've come from a load of different places and you've all put in the effort, so we really do appreciate it. I'm sure you'll agree we found a great location here in Ballymacarvey to celebrate the special day. So I just want to say a huge thanks to all the staff for all their hard work, both today and in the run-up. Especially Emer, who's not here today, but she's done a great job. She really has, keeping us on the ball and keeping us chugging at times when we kind of got a bit lax, which is probably 90% of the time myself. So thanks to Lorna for that as well, for pulling the weight when I didn't kind of, when I slicked off, as it were. So there's a few other people I'd like to get through. I'll keep it as brief as possible. First of all, to the lads, I just want to say a huge thanks for everything in the run-up to today, for all the advice, support, help, and just small little bits of running around you done, and the tunes. I'll get to that. We've had a load of great times and a load of great memories, a lot of which I can't mention. Some was for fear of stealing Sam's material, and some of which would have been inappropriate. So I'll just leave it at saying, thankfully, we've had far more good times than bad, and long may that continue to be the case. Following on from that, touching on what Sam said, I'd like to say a huge thanks to you all for putting up with 72 hours of trance music to be there for the stag. I know a lot of you don't like that at all, so I do appreciate the effort of chugging in, so thanks very much. On to Lorna's mates and the bridesmaids. First of all, obviously, you all look absolutely great today. I know you put in a lot of effort to getting ready, and you're up at an ungodly hour, so fair play to you, but it does show you look absolutely brilliant. Secondly, I just want to say on behalf of Lorna, I know she appreciates all the help you gave her in the run-up to today, both today and in the run-up to today. All the advice, small things, calling in for tea, chats, everything that really did help her over the last couple of weeks. So I think I can speak for her when I say thanks a million to you all. There's not a lot of groups of friends who are as close as you all are. I know she's lucky to have you, and she really does appreciate everything you do for her, so fair play to you all. And just really quickly to both groups of friends, to the lads and the girls, from both myself and Lorna, I just want to say a huge thanks for making the effort to get to know each other, and for every time we met up and had a night out, for like jumping on board. It's made today a lot easier, and it's made it a lot easier for myself and Lorna that we all get all. It's absolutely brilliant, so thanks a million. Okay, so next, I won't take too much more of your time, but I just want to say a huge thanks to Frank and Louise for welcoming me into your family so much from the moment I met you. I think the first time I met you, I was going out with Lorna about 3 weeks and ended up spending the night down in Clonmel. So considering I was going out with your only daughter, I probably deserved a far harsher reaction than I got, and welcome than I got. But you were absolutely brilliant. But being serious, thanks very much. You've been absolutely brilliant since the day I met you. It's been 7 years now, and you've welcomed me into your family so much. So thank you, and I can promise I'll look after your daughter. There's no worries there. To my own parents, Audrey and Tino, I just want to say, I probably don't say this enough, how grateful I am to both of you for everything you've done for me and for raising me and bringing me up the way you did. I wouldn't be where I am without you. I just want you to know how much I appreciate everything, and I love you both. So thanks very much. And following up from that to Sam, thanks a million for everything in the run-up to today. All the little donkey work I've made you do, wrecking your head with small things, buy me cufflinks, get me socks, make sure the suits are sorted, all the little stuff that would have gone unnoticed. So I really do appreciate it. Thanks a million. And it's been great having you back for a few months. Hopefully we'll get a few more months before you head off travelling again. So thanks very much. I'm nearly done. I won't take too much more of your time. I just want to mention everybody who took part in the ceremony today, to Grace and Sean, the flower girl and the page boy. You've done an absolutely brilliant job. I don't know where you are. One's over there, and Sean is over there. So thanks a million, guys. It was brilliant. To everybody who done the readings, the prayers of the faithful, carried up gifts, Everybody else who was involved, Monsignor Farrell, thanks a million for the ceremony. It was absolutely lovely. We really do appreciate it. And to everybody else involved, I've probably missed one or two people knowing me. So if I have missed you, I'm sure I'll remember later. So thanks a million. Also, I'd like to, she's not here, but I'd like to mention Ian Ramara for the lovely cake, which you'll see in a minute. She's done an absolutely great job. So Phil, you can tell her thanks a million. So that's pretty much it. But lastly, to my beautiful new wife, Lorna. I just want to say, I can't really put into words how lucky I am to have you and how happy I've been the last 7 years with you. I suppose at this point, usually you'd give like a funny story or something about a relationship. But I think probably the best thing would be the story how we met, which for anyone who doesn't know, we were both out on Minute, just on a random night out. I walked by, Lorna seen me, liked the look of me, said something to her friend. Her friend went up to get me. In the meantime, Lorna had done a runner. So when the friend got me, I didn't know what was going on. Thought she was making it up or whatever, but she found me again anyway. Introduced us a couple of hours later. We met, clicked, that was it, and the rest is history. So I really do love you more than anything. I really appreciate everything you do for me. So just finally to finish up, I just want to say you look absolutely gorgeous today. You really do. When I seen you in the church, it took me a couple of seconds to get my breath back. But once I did, I couldn't stop smiling, and I haven't stopped smiling since. I just want you to know how lucky I am both to have shared so many memories with you already, and how lucky I am to have the rest of my life with you, to look forward to so many more. So I just want to say I love you more than anything, and thanks for putting up with me the last 7 years. Okay, so I'll just ask you very quickly, I'll just ask you to all raise a glass to the beautiful bride. So, nice and quickly, to Lorna, everybody. Thanks a million. Cheers. Okay, so thanks for listening to me ramble. I'll pass you back over to Sam very briefly. I just want to say thanks a million to you all for coming, and have an absolutely brilliant day.
Yeah, okay, two things just before we let you go. Number one, we're about to cut the cake down the end, so make sure you all get a bit of that. And secondly, there's a glass frame in the bar. You might have seen it already. Just as little notes, it's like the guest book. Just write a little message on it, pop the heart into the glass frame, because that's going to be their memories for today. So make sure you all get a chance to sign that. As I said, cake is down there. Make sure you all enjoy yourself. And yeah, that's it. Happy days.
Sorry, I told you I would forget something. I do have a head like a sieve, as everyone who knows me will be able to attest it. So, myself and Lorna got flowers for both of our mothers, just to say a huge thank you for everything that you've done for us along the way. I did tell you I'd forget something, so I'm going to hand the mic to Sam, and thanks very much, Louise, on behalf of Lorna, and thanks very much to Ord on behalf of me.
Now we're going to cut the cake if you'd like to take some photos. Thank you.
here for Sean and Lorna.
You say be close behind, but I want you to see, I want you to always be mine. And I know they say you won't cry, but I'm thinking, would you be thinking of me too this night? And never stop and think before I speak, but you said you like that about me. So tell me more, pay your soul. I want to keep it all. Oh. I want to keep you warm. And it's a small thing.
Everyone up on the dance floor here tonight. We're here for a celebration, so let's everyone up on the dance floor and have some fun. We know you know this one.
I left a good job in the city.
Come on, let me hear you.
Working for the man every night and day. No, I never miss a minute of sleep. Yeah, thinking about the way things might have been. Big wheels. Keep on turning.
Come on!
And keep on burning.
You got it!
Rolling, 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 rolling on a river. On a river, rolling, 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 rolling on a job
Be cool, relax, yeah, get gotta be cool, relaxed. I can't hit, get on your tracks, take a backseat, be tired. Yeah, take a long ride on that motorbike. I'm ready, crazy little thing called love. Yeah, say, hold up, yeah, I just, I can't hear the little thing called love. Yeah, I just, I see if I can't get around to it. I'm ready, crazy little thing called love. Yeah, crazy little thing called love. Yeah, crazy little thing called love. Yeah, I got a crazy.